Namaskar students, today I am starting a new chapter of biology, that is chapter 15, our environment. In this chapter we are going to read about biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste, but before that we will come to know about what is our environment, then the ecosystem and its components, then food chain and food web, then trophic levels in a food chain, flow of energy, ecological pyramids, biomagnification and effects of human activities on the environment. Let's first know about what is our environment. Everything that surrounds an organism, like the physical and biological world, is called the environment of that organism. You know, we have the word environment often being used on the television, in newspaper and by people around us. It's a very common word that we use in day-to-day basis, right? You know, the environment includes physical surroundings like soil, water, air and all the living organisms like plants, animals, you know, and microorganisms. These various living and non-living components interact with each other and maintain a balance in the, you know, environment. Okay. So, in order to fulfill needs of food, clothing, transport, etc., human beings are damaging the balance and healthy environment. Now, in this chapter, we are going to learn about, or we'll try to understand how our activities are influencing the natural environment of the earth. So, the first thing we should know about that, the waste that we generate in day-to-day basis. Now, what is the effect of those waste to the environment? Now, if you need to define the waste, how we will write? The material that becomes useless after being used and needs to be discarded. It's called waste. As I said, every day, you know, we generate a lot of waste through our activities. This waste can be domestic, municipal, agricultural, hospital or industrial. All this waste material, you know, used to pollute our environment, whether it is air, water or soil. Now, the waste material produced are of mainly two types, or we can you know, categorize them or classify them into two main categories, that is biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. Let us know about the biodegradable waste first. Okay, now the waste materials that can be broken down into simple harmless substances by biological process are called biodegradable waste. You know, in biological process, various microorganisms such as bacteria and fungi, they decompose the biodegradable waste. These microorganisms release enzymes that act on the waste and break it down into smaller harmless substances. All this, you know, enzymes are specific in their action, and they can only break down the natural materials. Mind it, okay? Just underline that line, the natural materials or the products made from natural materials. Enzyme cannot break down various human-made materials like plastics. Now, in example of this biodegradable waste, you can write this cow dung, vegetables and fruit peels, cotton, jute, paper, wool, tea leaves, leather, animal products and agricultural products. Do you know the effects of this biodegradable waste? Let me tell you about that. You know, this decomposition of biodegradable substances produces foul smell that pollutes the surrounding environment. Don't think that that can be, you know, broken down by the microorganisms. That means they have no effect on us or our environment. They also have. We all know when they, you know, this degradation process starts, know that time it smells very badly, right? Now, disease carrying germs breed on the garbage heaps and spread diseases like typhoid, diarrhea and cholera. Sometimes heavy rainfall washes away this waste to the water sources and makes it unfit for use. That is why it is always we need to keep in the mind to, you know, produce as much as lesser waste as can be possible. Next is the non-biodegradable waste. Now, the waste materials that cannot be broken down into harmless substances by natural biological processes are called non-biodegradable waste. The non-biodegradable waste includes many man-made materials like plastics, polythene bags, you know, synthetic fibers, ballpoint pen, refills, glass items, aluminium cans, radioactive waste, then like DDT, all these are chemicals, mercury and lead. All these non-biodegradable waste cannot be broken down by the action of bacteria or other saprophytes. We know who are called the saprophytes, right? Okay, and hence they are major pollutants of the environment. You know, this DDT, or we know that it's a non-biodegradable waste which can enter the food chain from the crops. DDT is a chemical that spreads to kill the pests. Okay, we know that. So what happens when they this farmers spray it on the food material, the crops, they enters into it, and through the enters means not like that this crops can absorb them, but it coats on them. And if you are not washing properly, and if you wash also after that also, if some percentage of these chemicals will remain on the food materials, so it's very harmful for us, and it can cause serious health problems. Because of this reasons, no use of DDT as a pesticide is banned in most of the countries. But in our country, I think still we use lots of chemicals that should not be used. So we need to be aware of all this, right? Now, if I need to explain the effects of non-biodegradable waste in our environment, we can say that this waste substances enters the food chain through the crop fields and cause several health problems in living organisms, right? The harmful chemicals and pesticides seep into the soil also and contaminate groundwater source. Now, dumping of industrial waste on open field pollute soil, thus it reduces the fertility of the soil. So we need to think of it. As I said, we need to think the ways that the waste should be generated as lesser as can be possible. Now, let's see the difference between these biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Okay, as I said, the definition is already, I have explained, it is written in the first point. And then second one, it is written that they can be recycled naturally. And this non-biodegradable, they cannot be recycled naturally as well as by man, and their products cause environmental pollution. Now, then the third point is the waste are made up of natural ingredients. And this, as this non-biodegradable, we all know these wastes are made up of synthetic materials. The fourth one you can write, they can produce, means this biodegradable waste can be can produce useful products after biodegradation, like compost and all. And they remain, this non-biodegradable remain unchanged chemically as they are non-biodegradable. That means the microorganism cannot degrade this waste. Now, the biodegradable waste, they do not disturb the ecological balance in nature, But as we know that because this non-biodegradable waste cannot be broken down by the microorganisms, they remains in the nature for many years. And thus, they can, you know, disturb the balance, ecological balance in the nature. Now, biological or this biodegradable waste persists for small time intervals in the environment as microbes are there to degrade them. But as we all know, this non-biodegradable persists for longer time intervals in the environment. Examples already I have discussed. So, please note down in your note copy. Today up to this, in my next video, I will discuss about the ecosystem. Namaste.